Hey, hey. Good morning, or good night, wherever you are in the world. In this video, we are going to talk about everything and nothing, as we say in my native tongue. I have been so blown away by all of the requests this week and this month. For me to just do a simple rambling whispering video, and here it is. And in preparation for this video, I did two things. Number one, I had cereal with nails and poured it over with volcanic rock in order to get my voice as crinkly and as growly as possible for you. But the second thing is I was just thinking about what to talk about, because rambling, isn't that just like I'm talking to myself? But then I realized that that's exactly what this is. And I'm just like, isn't that what you've been doing for the past 2 years, Fedica? Just talking to yourself and cool people on the internet think it's cool and listen to? Anyway, I just woke up. I woke up maybe 30 minutes ago, and I know that that's like, oh, you've been up. No. One thing you need to know about little old Felka is she is so sleepy in the morning. It's kind of embarrassing. Wait, what? Why am I starting with this? I'm starting with outing myself as a sleepy, sleepy, sleepy girl. At any rate, it's bad. Anytime I have a sleepover with a friend, I preface, by the way, I will be sleeping for approximately 12 hours. So wake me up whenever you get up. And even then, I'll probably take a long time to stir and wake up. So don't be surprised if it takes a while. Now, I don't say it like that to my friends. I don't say it in an ASMR tingly way. Though some friends wish I did. Oh. This is random. I'm looking around my apartment, and one thing you should know about me, other than I'm the sleepiest girl in the world, is that Furka has many, many, many projects just open. I look at my sewing machine. I look at my pile of books that I want to mend. Oh my god, I have so much stuff to do. Anyway, there is one project in particular that I really want to get to today. Furka is no stranger to using the third person, apparently. How weird. I guess it's like because I'm more aware that I'm talking to myself. Because, side note, when I record the role plays for you guys, I really do imagine like I'm talking to you. You. There's someone else in the room, someone else reacting. Maybe that makes me crazy. Now that I think about it. When I really am just talking to myself. But I think you guys always say that, like, oh, Fedka, like, you are so unlike other ASMR artists. And I think that that is it. That might be it. This kind of total immersive experience that I create. It's totally for you. But I hope that makes sense. It makes sense in my brain. I gotta be honest. There's something bugging me. Literally bugging me. I have a mosquito bite on the side of my foot. I have really nice feet, you guys. That's something you should know. Apart from this mosquito bite that's making it really itchy, and I'm trying my best not to itch it, because as we all know, the more you itch it, the more it gets itchy. I was camping with some friends last weekend, and We were having a lovely time. It was just one, two, it was just the four of us. And I built a fire for us, being the only capable person around. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. My friends are very capable people, but not in the fire building department. Can you hear me itching it against the rug? Ah, I should stop. I should stop. But I suspect that that is when I got this mosquito bite, because when else do you have your feet out? We were actually, we put our feet right by the fire to warm us up, because it was kind of cold. It was really strange, the fact that it was so cold, for this part of the U.S. But, you know, we said whatever. It's cool. We can have our dogs out by the fire. Little dog burn session. But my one friend, Kevin, he got his feet too close to the fire and his shoes started to melt. And I told him, Kevin, your shoes are melting. And he said, no, Felka, what are you talking about? These are just good rubber shoes. And he touched it. Maybe it wasn't melting, but it was. Really, really, really hot. I'm looking around my room and I wonder. Well, I think that let me start by saying that art, as soon as it goes out into the world, I don't think it's the artists anymore. I think that as soon as art makes it into the world, it is yours. Your experience with it. That is what it is. It's yours. Everybody has a different interpretation of something, so it has a million different faces, and with that, I think that everybody has a different experience with these audios. Everybody comes from a different place. Everybody hears something different, right? Focuses on something. Then the other might not. And really always so curious to hear what you guys, how you perceive it got to be, whether that be short or feisty or tidy or just a mess. But let me tell you, let me shatter that reality for some of you, because Felka, well, very tidy, very clean, I'm Polish after all. I am a collector. I collect books. I collect experiences. I collect memories. And I collect those little Russian nesting dolls. I only have one, but I like to think that I collect them. You know, it's my friend is very against the war in Ukraine, and of course, glory to Ukraine, glory to Ukraina. To all of the Ukrainian listeners, I send you my love. But she saw that I have a Russian nesting doll, and she would not let me go. She just said, how dare you have such a symbol of hatred? And I agreed with her. But, I'm hungry. I agreed with her, but I also said that it's a Ukrainian thing, actually. I remember в Польщі, we would go to Litva and Czech and just travel around, and I would see them oftentimes on the Sunday markets, people selling their wares and their old stuff. God. You guys have no idea how much I miss home, how much I long for it every day. I have the lockbox my grandmother gave me and the rosary that my mom gave me when I was a kid, and I think about them. Honestly, I don't know how much longer I can take it. I think I'm gonna have to go back pretty soon because I really do miss my siblings and they miss me, and I often don't talk about how much I love the US though, so maybe I could talk about that for once. I kind of hate on it, you know, being like, oh, nobody I love is here. Well, maybe they are and I just haven't found them yet. You guys know that I'm a hopeless romantic. You know that. I guess we could talk about love. Love. The power of love. Baby, love. I have so many old records that I play at night. Just in my feels, as they say, listening to these old records of love and longing and loss, and I just wonder where my person is. You know, they say that you have multiple small mates. Small mates. They're just really small. You have multiple small mates, yeah, yeah, in the world. And it's not just one person that you're meant to be with. I know that that's a very romantic belief that, oh, this is the one person for me, but that's just not true. But I do wonder if one of those people happens to be in the same place that I am. Because it kind of feels like they're not. But that's okay. It's okay because life is long. And so is my patience. Long. Angry. I guess we could talk about this. I am not on the dating apps. I don't think you guys would be very surprised to hear that. I don't know. They just have never worked for me. And they've never worked for my friends. So we kind of have all just concluded that it's a big waste of time. Even though it gives you this illusion of having so many people at your fingertips. Really, everyone's just looking for... Really, everyone, or most people on there are just looking for a snack. And I guess I'm looking for a 12-course meal. Drawn out with sultry... mood, music, and candlelight. And there's a cat walking around in the background, and there's wine, and there's the best dessert you've ever had. That's the kind of love I'm looking to cook together and dress together. Not a snack. Definitely not. I also look around my room, and I see so much potential. You guys ever think about getting older in a good way? I think that most people look at getting older as something that they're scared of. Because, oh, wrinkles, and oh no, time lost, regret. But I look around my room and I see all the things that I still want to learn. I see my Russian textbooks that I never really picked up. I see my guitar, that I know I can be so much better at. And so I look around my room and I think, wow, in 20 years, in 30 years, Fedka's gonna be so cool. Fedka's gonna be able to speak Russian again fluently and play the most beautiful Andalusian music on that guitar, on that shitty thrift store guitar that totally needs to be restringed. Maybe the Arabic textbooks too. Maybe you'll be able to read Arabic this time. Not maybe, for sure. You guys always ask me how I can do so much, how I can get so much done in a week, a month. And I think the secret for yourself is just to make lists. Yeah, it's that simple. You just make a list and cross it off and you'll feel super motivated to get everything done. That was really toxic of me to say. Sorry, guys. I'm still scratching the mosquito bite. I know no end of suffering, okay? But no, really, I think that the reason why I am the way I am is because I have something bigger motivating me. I get so much done. The reason why is because I can go so I can make my family proud and go back home and make my family proud, right? So.
I think I'm going to whisper for the rest of the audio. Or at least speaking softly. Which, from what I gather from being in the ASMR community for almost 3 years now, which, happy birthday to the channel, to the main channel. Apparently, it's a really big discussion whether whispering or speaking softly is better. Is better for falling asleep. And it's better for ASMR triggers. And how exactly did I find this debate? Well, you guys are going to be really excited to hear this, actually. That little old Vodka has been dabbling in actually doing ASMR. Not just role plays, but truly dedicated videos for ASMR triggers. I am so excited to start this. I bought a new microphone. I got new software. I got new underwear. I'm so excited. I watched all of the how to do ASMR videos and I felt like I was starting fresh. It was really exciting. So over the next few weeks, you guys are going to see more ASMR videos on this channel. I hope you like them, and honestly, I really don't know where to start, so if you guys can comment down below what you would like to see for specific ASMR trigger videos, I'd love to do them for you.
I would love to do them for you.
With that being said, I hope you guys have a restful night's sleep,
or
restful morning, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for subscribing and liking these videos. It really means a lot, since the second channel needs a whole lot more love to catch up with the main channel. You guys know that I'm not competing with anybody else, just myself. So I'd like to be a little bit better with every day. So, with that being said, thank you for looking forward to all the next audios to come. Thank you for supporting this new venture of ASMR dedicated videos, and I will talk to you guys soon. Love you. Mean it.